minute.
Grab that. Grab it.
I mean, I think it's just from not sleeping deeply. I don't think it's...
Yeah, I didn't have the cough. But I had, even when I got pneumonia, then...
When I first got it, I had, like, when you go through the list of symptoms, I had, like, all of them.
My son and his wife.
Yes, you might have to pull it 4 months ago.
Good morning. Oh, no. Did you get it?
She said the summer's gonna be over before it gets set up. What can you do?
Come here, bud. Do you wanna hand these out?
Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes. They've got about live streaming here, but that was just...
No, we're not live streaming.
But you have a camera pointed at me.
That's right. You said you wanted a recording.
Okay, that's good. That's okay. We have a beautiful day to be here. We lucked out again. I'm just surprised there aren't more people. It's the last two times we've done this. We've had a lot of people. It's just great to see everyone here, and I know a lot of people have been sick in the last couple of weeks, but you're on the mend, and so it's great to be here. I brought my worship flags with me today because they're hand-painted silk, and they're designed with the colors of creation. It's a way of worshiping with movement. So if anyone would like to, and the music's playing, pick up a flag and just let it blow and move with you, feel free to do that. It is, they're called worship flags for reasons. It is praying in a different way. So this, when we have the opportunity to come together on a fifth Sunday, we usually have a theme. And this, a couple of months ago, I know the lay ministers, some of the congregation members who aren't here today, were asking about what can we do to celebrate the ministry of the licensed lay ministers, because they have been doing so much. I was off and then I got COVID, and they're there. They're working every second Sunday as well, but that they took on extra. So when we were planning the fifth Sunday service and what to do, and the idea was maybe we can come together outside and celebrate the ministry of the licensed lay ministers together. So we don't have that many of you here. Gladys, Deborah, and Julie behind me. I'm just looking behind me. So.
And Dave.
You didn't clear your throat out.
No.
I guess not.
I didn't forget about you. You're like at the top of the list. So if you have your service bulletin, and everything is in there. I chose readings especially for today. So it's not the regular plan. Did we miss you, Gladys?
Avery has one.
Avery's passing them out.
Okay.
She got one, Avery.
Yes.
Okay.
She was getting up to go.
Yeah. She wanted to bring it to you.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Yeah. So, our opening sentence for today is, for even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. Our opening hymn, and Julie has printed words, so you should all have a copy of that in your bulletin as well. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, we are all baptized by the one Spirit into one body and given gifts for a variety of ministries for the common good. Our purpose today is to recognize and affirm the ministry for which our licensed lay ministers have offered themselves. So I have a question for you licensed lay ministers, two of which are over there. Question is for all of you. Is it your will that these licensed lay ministers continue to fulfill this ministry?
It is.
Licensed lay ministers, you have been called to this ministry Will you, as long as you are engaged in this work, perform it with care to the honor of God and the benefit of the church?
I will.
I will. Will you continue to uphold them in this service?
We will.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, gracious God, our Creator and Redeemer. In every age you call people to minister in your name. May the work of these your servants so build up your church that we may faithfully serve you and show you love in all the world. Blessed are you, O God, now and forever. Amen. May the Lord enable and uphold you in this ministry. Let us pray the collect. Almighty God, by your grace alone, we are accepted and called to your service. Strengthen us by your Holy Spirit, and make us worthy of your calling. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Now we will have the proclamation of the word, and I did not ask anybody to read. This is a day for the licensed lay ministers to have up, but I know Deborah's ready to pounce any second to read. And if you feel you would like to read, Deborah, go right ahead.
She can get up off the blanket.
A reading from Exodus. Moses said to the Lord, "See, you have said to me, bring up this people, but you have not let me know whom you will send with me. Yet you have said, I know you by name, and you have also found favor in my sight. Now, if I have found favor in your sight, please show me your ways, so that I may know you and find favor in your sight. Consider, too, that this nation is your people," he said. "My presence will go with you, and I will give you rest." And he said to him, "If your presence will not go, do not bring us up from here. For how shall it be known that I have found favor in your sight, I and your people, unless you go with us? In this way we shall be distinct, I and your people, from every people on the face of the earth." The Lord said to Moses, "I will also do this thing that you have asked, for you have found favor in my sight, and I know you by name." Moses said, "Please show me your glory." And he said, "I will make all my goodness pass before you, and will proclaim before you the name, the Lord. And I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and I will show mercy to whom I will show mercy. But," he said, "you cannot see my face, for no one shall see me and live." And the Lord continued, "See, there is a place by me where you shall stand on the rock, and while my glory passes by, I will put you in a cleft of the rock, and I will cover you with my hand until I have passed by. Then I will take away my hand, and you shall see my back, but my face shall not be seen." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Someone else put a song. Yeah, but does somebody like to lead us in the song? See, the licensed slave ministers are coming forward. Even though I told them
Our psalm today is Psalm 96, and we will read it responsively by the half verse. Sing to the Lord a new song.
Sing to the Lord, all the world.
Sing to the Lord and bless his name.
Proclaim the good news of his salvation from day to day.
Declare his glory among the nations
and his wonders among all peoples.
For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised.
He is more to be feared than all of us.
As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols.
But it is the Lord who made the heavens.
Oh, the majesty and magnificence of his presence.
Oh, the power and splendor of his sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples.
Ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name.
Bring offerings and come into his courts.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness.
Let the whole earth tremble before him.
Let it out among the nations. The Lord is King.
He has made mortals so firm that they cannot be moved. He will judge his people justly.
Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder, and all that is in it.
Let the fields be joyful, and all that is therein.
Then shall all the trees of the wood shout for joy before the Lord when he comes.
When he comes to judge the earth.
He will judge the world with righteousness.
And the peoples with his truth.
And together, we worship you, God of glory, in the beauty of holiness. And we joyfully proclaim your just and righteous rule, established for all through your Son, Jesus Christ, the Lord.
The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up of the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of the faith, and of the knowledge of the Son of God to maturity, to the measure of full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children, tossed to and fro, and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery, by their craftiness in deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body, joined and knitted together by every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body growth in building itself up in love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gradual hymn has the deer pants for water.
Thanks for the deer.
Beautiful voices.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The apostle said to the Lord, increase our faith. The Lord replied, if you had faith the size of a mustard seed, you could say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it would obey you. Who among you would say to your slave who has just come in from plowing or tending sheep in the field, come here at once and take your place at the table? Would you not rather say to him, prepare supper for me, put on your apron and serve me while I eat and drink? Later you may eat and drink. Do you thank the slave for doing what was commanded? So you also, when you have done all that you were ordered to do, say, we are worthless slaves. We have done only what we have ought to have done. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I speak to you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I put together an actual reflection, short though it is, a little more put together than last year when I was just winging it. So today, we come together and we celebrate the ministry of all Christians to love God and neighbors. And as we heard in Paul's letter to the Ephesians, we all have been given gifts. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ. On this day, we particularly give thanks for and celebrate the minister of the licensed lay ministers who serve ACPC and St. George's. I know they only have one, Joel, and he's not here, but we will celebrate him as well. Each of them has answered a call that fulfills God's deep purpose for them, even though discerning that call is ongoing. All ministry is relational. As disciples living a faithful life in Christ, we share in God's mission and purpose for the world to build up the body of Christ. And as Moses learned from God, my presence will go with you and I will give you rest. We're never alone. And often it's the most likely people who are called to ministry, like Moses. But we need to have faith and trust in the Lord's direction. God does not call the equipped. God equips the called. In today's gospel, the disciples have asked Jesus for more faith. If you remember over the last few weeks, we've been learning a lot about discipleship, had the Good Samaritan, and the people who ignored the suffering and crossed to the other side of the road to avoid it. But we also learned of the one who did take care of it. We had Mary and Martha. Martha was afraid that she was doing all the work, but actually she was multitasking. You know, us women know how to cook in the kitchen and do all the dishes, but we can still listen to Jesus. Men, give you the benefit of the doubt. Multitasking is hard. That's what I've been told anyway over the years. Jesus begins by comparing faith to a tiny mustard seed. But he goes on to explain that it isn't how much faith you have that matters. It's how you use it. Jesus says it doesn't take much faith to do great things. The tiniest amount of faith can plant a tree in the ocean or move a mountain from one place to another. Mustard weeds also propagate through bird droppings. They were such a nuisance plant at Jesus' time, so people would understand what he was talking about. They were so difficult to get rid of. The plants grow rapidly, more than 6 feet tall. And they spring up in the middle of wheat fields, and they block the sun from the growing grain. And it didn't do much to just pull them up, because the birds would eat the seeds and they would be dropped all over. So it was spreading them around. Mustard seeds are tiny, but they sure had an impact. Maybe what we need is the kind of faith that, like mustard weed, spreads contagiously wherever it is dropped, grows persistently, and cannot be easily destroyed. When we understand that faith is trusting God, we can begin to live out that trust through discipline and humility, becoming true servants of God to do the work that God has given us to do. And as we do, we will promise to uphold one another through our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, and our witness. God has already given you all the faith you need. Instead of asking for more faith or bigger faith, the disciples should have been finding opportunities to act on the faith they already have. We need to be more faithful, serving with no expectation of praise or recognition, in true humility. And I just want to speak to that sentence here. Serving with no expectation of praise or recognition in true humility. And as I mentioned in the beginning, the idea for this came up at Christ Church from some parishioners who wanted to recognize the ministry. But I heard from these licensed lay ministers, we don't need recognition. Thank you. We didn't want anything special, but it is only right, because we all appreciate and give thanks for your ministry. We celebrate you all today. Our obedience is by no means a way to gain honor, and good works aren't something we do in order to receive a reward. We obey and serve because Christ calls us to follow him in obedient service. He gives us plenty of faith to do this, but it's up to us to act on it. And we are reminded that we can be believers in isolation, but to become true and faithful disciples, we need to live out that faith in community. Faith depends on community. Faith is trust, and trust requires relationship. As we put our trust in Jesus, we give up any illusion of depending on ourselves only, and we recognize that faith cannot be measured, it can only be lived. You have to be present to participate in the full life of the body of Christ. Even though that is changing because of the pandemic, as we do share together spiritually, virtually, we are together, but not in person all together. your presence among the people of God is not only important to you, it's important to the rest of us. We promise our gifts, not only our offerings and our tithes, but our spiritual gifts to help build up the body. Trust God. Be faithful. Have a contagious kind of faith that can't help but share the good news. This is discipleship. We have plenty of faith. It only takes faith the size of a mustard seed, dropped where it can take root, to do what God is calling us to do. God is calling us to promise our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, and our witness. As we live out our faith together in this community we call church. Faith will not, however, change the circumstances of our lives. Rather, it changes us. Living in faith does not shield us from the pain and difficulties of life. It doesn't undo the past, and it will not guarantee a particular future. Faith is the means by which we face and deal with the circumstances of life, the difficulties and the losses, the joys and the successes, the opportunities and the possibilities. Faith does not get you a pat on the back, a reward, or a promotion in God's eyes. It is practiced day after day in the ordinary, everyday circumstances. And some days when the pain and heaviness of life seem more than we can carry, it is by faith, relationship with Jesus, that we get up each morning and face the reality of life. When we feel the pain of the world and respond with compassion, we speak for justice, we feed the hungry, we house the homeless. We accept all races, ethnicities, and sexual orientations. When we experience the brokenness of a relationship and offer forgiveness and mercy, when we see the downtrodden and offer our presence and prayers, in all these we have lived, seen, and acted by faith, and the presence of God is always with you. And now we're going to confess our faith. You can stand or just stay seated, it's fine. I'm just going to have a drink of water.
Is it stand or sit? That would be enough.
Let us confess our faith as we say. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Begotten, not made, but one being with the Father, through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation, him down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Our litany response is, Lord, here I am.
Lord, here I am.
Now, Abraham was the first to go and must have been a brave man, because you did not say where he was going, and still he followed your command. He shows us that when you ask us to move, we should say,
Lord, here I am.
There are many who are bold, and in your name take a stand when your people are hurting each other in ways we can't comprehend. Without a moment's hesitation, they say to you,
Lord, here I am.
When we hear tales of injustice and oppression happening across your vast land, we believe you want us to respond, to be your feet, to be your hands. And while I don't know the work you need me to do,
Lord, here I am.
You are working through our lives to fulfill your mighty will and plan. And it requires a submission we sometimes cannot understand. But as you promise to never forsake us, we each say,
Lord, here I am.
Almighty God, giver of all good gifts, we praise and thank you for the many varied skills and talents you have showered upon your sons and daughters for the building up of your kingdom here on earth. We praise you for the gift your Spirit has inspired in these your servants, that they may in turn place them at the service of the church. Bless them and the ministry they undertake to spread the gospel of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to all who long to experience your love in their lives. We ask you to strengthen them in body, mind, and spirit, so that the lives they lead as your children and the work they do in your name may give glory and praise to you forever and ever.
Amen.
Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry. We humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may be light and light in all will, and walk in all your ways, to the glory of your name. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I'll leave it up to you to exchange a sign of the peace as you are comfortable. Peace of Christ. Our offertory hymn. Oh, here I am. By the Lord of sea and sky, here I am. Lord, the light of your love is... In peace, let us pray. O God, we give you thanks for uniting us as the body of Christ and for filling us with joy at this table. Lead us toward the unity of your church and help us treasure signs of reconciliation. Now that we have tasted the banquet you have prepared for us, may we one day feast together in your heavenly city through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end. Amen. May the peace of God that passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all this day and with those you love, and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
Anyone have anything they'd like to announce today? Since I start vacation tomorrow, but I am available. Be working the week of between the 22nd and 28th of July. So if there are any pastor, pardon?
August.
What did I say?
You said July.
July. See? My brain.
That week's over.
Yeah, it's the COVID brain. I say things that aren't right and anyway.
Can you blame that on COVID if you haven't had COVID?
Yeah, I know. Someone said, so what else is new? Yeah, so I will be available that week if anybody needs pastoral care or whatever. I will be around. Joanne is taking care of emergency pastoral care as well. She'll be available. All the information for contacts are available. So the board needs our context as well. But our Reverend Joanne is quite capable of handling all things. Anything else?
Yeah.
You have anything to say, Nixon? Nothing to say? How was the service? Good. Ready to eat now, Michael? You hungry for picnic? Okay. We're going to have our final hymn.
Yes.
No one else? Okay.
I think this is Carol's favorite.
Yeah, she loves it. Take a play!
Yeah, it's No.
You think you have the form? Let us go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord and enjoy a time of fellowship and food together on this glorious day.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Thank you, Julie.
She wears many hats. This is one of the ministries she should have had in there. And some are called to be musicians. And some are called to be techies. Dave has recorded this.
I think.
For all of the ministries that each one of you do, thanks be to God.